I'm getting into the specialty items now. So I'm going to start showing you some special nuts. This is what they call a left-hand jam nut. You see it's a low profile. Okay. The only way you can tell left-hand is it has an arrow right there. And that arrow shows it turning to the left. And that's the only way you're going to know when you have a left-hand nut. You got to look for that arrow. If you have that arrow exists, then it's a left-hand nut. This is a reducer. So you can see on one side, it has 3/8, 16. And this side has 1/2 inch, 13. So you can literally go, if you had some threaded rod and you want to reduce it down to a smaller size, or the opposite, where you want it to go from 1/2 13 to 3/8 16, you'd use this reduce coupling nut, they call it. And that's the way that that would work there. And this is a standard coupling nut. They come in various sizes and lengths, different thread pitches, fine, coarse thread. All these items I'm showing you do come in coarse and fine thread. This is a knurled nut, commonly used in chandeliers, tattoo machines, many, many different types of finished applications these are used in. These are the type of things you put on with your thumbs. Don't usually use a wrench on this type of a nut. That's the same thing with a wing nut. Wing nuts are always used for thumbs. No wrenches involved in these nuts. Next I have are cap nuts. So you have low profile, high crown, and then we have two tall. We have two tall and a flathead. And we have two tall and a rounded head. Now, the two tall come fully threaded all the way to the inside, to the top. So you have full threads all the way through. You have on a two tall what they call a flat top. So you can see the top is flat and it has a chamfered edge around it. And the rounded top is just rounded over like the standard cap knot at the top. They call these two tall because they're approximately, if you took the high crowns, they're approximately double the height, almost. Okay? But if you had the high two high crowns, I don't have two high crowns here, but if I did, it'd be close to the size, and that's why they call it a two tall. I have here what they call a T-nut. T-nuts are used mostly in wood. Most common, they do use it in plastics also. T-nut is made to go in, the hole is drilled into the wood or into a plastic product. And then these prongs that you see here, they come in 3-prong, 4-prong. This particular one has 4 prongs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 prongs. And then it has this barrel, they call this a barrel. And you push it into the hole that you drilled, and then you suck the screw in, and this flattens right out with the wood, typically. Very commonly used nut. A castle nut. These are typically used in cars. You'll find them on axles when they hold on wheels and bearings. Rotors. We're going to drill out a bolt, slide the cotter pin in to show you how this is locked in place.